division out. And in these same terms, that's the sacred masculine. Now, we talked about the masculine, who oppressed and limited and all. That's not the sacred masculine. That would be more like the wounded masculine. The one who feels so gripped by fear of what could be that they oppress and keep you suppressed so that there's no getting out. Or so so worried and how it's going to happen that they just frozen. You know, I'm just not going to do anything because I might get wrong. You know, that's also wounded. That's not moving in the world. And I did a lot of that. I have a lot of outlines and spreadsheets on how I can do different things. But none of them manifested because I just couldn't get beyond that planning and organizing. So what I needed, I realized, was the sacred masculine. The masculine part of me that sees the feminine and not just, you know, sees that, you know, anybody see Avatar? Avatar scenes where they really see you. They see the vision and they say, cool vision. What do we need to do? Let's move with it. So it's this back and forth of every step is, I think this is next. Okay, how do we get that? And then I think this is next. So much so that the masculine and feminine work side by side, hand in hand, indistinguishable with one another. And you don't even call it sacred masculine and feminine. You know, so that's what I was going. I needed that jointness. I needed something to provide action for me. So Athena. Athena is a Greek goddess, and she is known for being both masculine and feminine. Feminine form, but she's a goddess of creativity and of warfare. She can blend the two with ease. She's the goddess of wisdom and intuition and courage and moving with honest forthrightness swiftly. So she's a combination of both, and I thought maybe working on her would be the same. And I actually experienced this. We renovated a house a few years ago, and I found that process to be very similar. I found, of course, Joel and I worked together indistinguishably. You know, anybody could talk to either one of us and know exactly what was going on with the contractors and whatever. And I found it in myself in that we had this vision. We could see exactly what needed to be done, and I could act on it. And I could call them, and then I could go back to the vision. And we could go back and forth, and it was seamless. And it happened in 5 months, which is unusual to renovate a house. Okay, it went completely new, but for all kinds of reasons. It was a quick process because it was a back and forth, seamless, masculine, feminine working together. That's how I felt about it. So I did this, I finished this a few months ago because I had a show. But I wanted her in there, you know, and sometimes you need that sacred masculine deadline saying, come on, you can do this. And I'd say, what have I done? What have I committed to? This is ridiculous. I'm not doing it anyway. And then I would get back to her. So Athena often has a shield. Most of the goddesses, especially warfare, and her shield usually has Medusa with the snakes because she helped Perseus. She helped Perseus kill Medusa, and so that shield for her is a symbol of what empowers her and what she's capable of. I didn't need any more snakes on this one. So I did what empowers me is this body of work that has helped me in the last 10 years. Come to myself more, become more whole. So I did a shield or a halo, perhaps, of that. She also carries a spear because she is very courage. I didn't want a spear. I wanted something a little bit more gentle to move into the world. So I chose butterflies. But butterflies, if you don't know, I'm sure you do, they're caterpillars to start. And then they completely change their DNA structure and become a butterfly. It's the only species that does that complete transformation to the point where they are unrecognizable at the end from their former self. Sound like anybody? I sort of felt like that. And so I thought the butterfly was good. I read one place that the caterpillar never questions. It's not like, you know, well, you know, this isn't a good sign. I think I'll wait. If you just give me, or I really love rooting around on your lead. Do I, you want me to fly? Are you kidding me? You want me, you know, none of that. It just says, oh, it's time? It's time. Okay, I'm going to go, I'm going to transform, I'm going to become who I am, and then I'm going to release and move on. So that's why there's a bunch of butterflies, because I'm hoping that, you know, I transform osmosis-wise, this becomes what I'm aiming for. So that's what this is, the next step of the process. And there will be more. Soon mm-hmm. there won't be a decade of renewing, because we'll be beyond a decade. Right? Mm-hmm. I'll talk about another name. But that's where I'm at. And I, you know, it's like I said, I've been in my studio, I've written, I've got thousands of pages of writings and things like that, but I've never told this out loud. And so I thank you.
When do we leave for Mexico?
I'll leave tomorrow.
We have a family friend. She's Mexican. She went to college with my sister-in-law. And so, you know, I just saw her last weekend at a wedding. She comes for everything. Hershey is her name. We call her Dirty Miss or something. But she is. She lives within viewing distance of Frida Kahlo's house. And I am. I would like to go visit her, and I love flying to the Capitol to come and all of that stuff. On my list, on my short list. We had to go to Asia.
Rough.
She's like,